Hello and welcome to my Geck tutorial on how to make an NPC for Fallout 3 or Fallout New Vegas. An NPC means non-playable character. These are the creatures or people you see in a game that you cannot control yourself. For example, in Fallout 3 you've got Moriarty, you've got Garb and you've got Sarah Lyons. In New Vegas you've got Victor and you've got Yes Man, you've got Securitrons, and you've got all sorts of other people around to talk to and everything. So, here's how you make an NPC. First, you'll want to boot up the Geck and load the Fallout 3 or Fallout New Vegas ESM. So be sure to open that and press OK. Now, depending on how fast your computer is will depend on how fast it loads up in the Geck. Okay, now once that's done, be sure to save it straight away so that you have a plugin that's already ready to be loaded and saved to. This saves time. So we're going to call this My NPC and we're going to save that. Be sure to save often. Don't save as often as I do. Just save whenever you feel like it. The Geck is prone to crash, so just save whenever you can. Now, in the object window you see here, we're going to want to create the NPC. You'll want to navigate your way to the actor data area, and underneath it is actors. Here's the NPC part. Just click on there and it will load every NPC that is in the game. You'll want to right click and click new. This will create an absolute brand new NPC that can be anything you choose it to be. Now, first things first, before we even make it, we're going to need to give it a specific ID. Now, for the tutorial purposes, I'm going to call it My NPC. The name of it, you can name, this is what you'll see in game. So if it says talk to such and such a person, it will say that name. So we're going to call him Bob. Of course you can name it whatever you want. Now, as you can see here, there are different buttons. Essential means that he just won't die in the game. You can kill him and kill him and kill him and he'll just keep standing up as if nothing happened. Probably remain hostile. It depends how you edit him. So if you click respawn, if you take that to be respawn, once he's been killed, he will come back in about 3 days' time. It depends how often you have the cells respawn everything. These are all self-explanatory. No knockdowns, no VATS melee, can be all races. That doesn't really matter. These are all ready human. I think that means it can be a dog or whatever. A quest item makes him specific to a part of quest. We're not going to be using that. And no low level processing means he won't be thick half the time. So we're going to want to tick that. I don't want him to be essential, but I do want him to come back if he dies after about 3 days. Now, his race can be whatever you want it to be. As you can see, there's African American, Asian, Asian old, ancient old aged. They're all there, even ghoul. You can make raiders. It depends exactly what you want him to be. For now, I'm going to have him as a ghoul. If you want, you can click on the preview of the head or preview in full body. There we are. Now, to change it into a female, all you have to do is tick the female and it will load into a female. Oh, that doesn't look good. But yeah, for now I'll have him as male. His height, this doesn't always matter, but it's usually best to set it to 1. That is the default height of all NPCs, except for Sharon. I think he's like 1.1, so like 1.3, and he's much taller. But we'll have him an average guy for now. Weight doesn't really matter in this game. It's practically pointless. The voice type is what voice it will use if you choose to have him to have voice dialogue. We're not going to be doing that. His class will be whatever he is. Usually I just put anything. It's really pointless, so I'll just leave it with Pulp Dweller. Disposition is his alignment, whether he's good, bad, evil. If he's very good, if you kill him, you lose karma. If he's very evil, you gain karma for killing him. I usually just keep him to neutral because it depends what you want his use to be. This is death items. This is the items he will hold when he dies. Now, if they're already not in his inventory, which I'll show in a minute, that will show the inventory and the death item. But for now, we're just going to have the death items to know. Combat style, this is the way he will fight. So if he's ever in a fight, this is how he'll fight. We don't want him to fight like that, do we? We want him to fight. We could have him default combat melee, range style, sniper. We're going to have him as ranged, light range. Now let's move on to the stats. Once you've done all the traits and everything, you're going to want the leveling data. Now, if you want him to be a specific level and a specific strength, just change the level of that. If you want him to level when the PC, as in the player character, levels yourself, then you tick that and he will go up. Every time you go up a level, he will get better. This is handy when you're making an enemy, because then your enemy will get be around your strength every time you level. Instead of just being a set level, you get to really high, you come up to him and he's just a weakling. So we'll just have him like that. Base health, this is his health that he'll have in game. Usually I set it to around 200 because I just like them to last a little bit in a fight instead of just dying straight away. None of this really matters much. It depends if you want him to be good at shooting or anything, you can just change all these. Now let's move on to the factions part. This part is probably one of the most important parts to do. Factions. You want him to... It depends what you want him to be friendly with. If you want him to be friendly against someone but be enemies against others, you'll put him in a specific faction. Say, if you put him in the Brotherhood of Steel faction, they'll be enemies with the Enclave. And vice versa if you put him in the Enclave faction. It's the way it's all, the way the factions are all made. So if you put him into the player faction, he'll practically be your friend. But we're not going to be using the factions part for now. But I suppose I could just add one now to show you. So we'll just click on Edit. Click on New. And then scroll down to about Megaton. Megaton Settler faction. This means he'll be friendly with Megaton Settlers. It's basically that's all self-explanatory. AI data. This is the way he'll act when he's in a fight or anything else. AI attributes. Aggression. Now, if he is unaggressive, he will not fight back. If you fight him, he'll basically ignore you and run away if his confidence is low enough. If he's aggressive, he'll fight back. He'll fight back if you hit him. If you make him very aggressive, he'll attack any of his enemies on sight. Maybe even everyone else. Frenzied means he will attack everyone. Everyone, including his friends. So that's the way that works. Confidence, if you want him to be cowardly, he'll run away from all the fights. If he's cautious, he'll run away from some fights. If he's average, he'll run away from some but fight some. If he's brave, he'll fight but may run away. If he's foolhardy, he'll never run away. He will fight to the death. Or to the death of his enemies. So we'll have him to foolhardy, just so he doesn't. Assistance. If he helps nobody, he'll help himself. Only himself. If his allies are being fought, he'll join in. He'll help them. Friends and allies. Allies are more than friends. They're like your brothers. Friends are just friends. But if your friends are being attacked, they'll help friends as well. Usually I just stick it into friends and allies because in real life you would help out your friends, really, wouldn't you? Mood. I've never found a use for this. So I just ignore that. The rest of it's all unimportant. If you're using him as a vendor, you'll want him to have repair and everything. Now, we're going to move on to show you AI packages later on in the tutorial. For now, I'm going to show you the inventory. This is what he will be holding that is accessible to practically everyone in the game. So if he dies, you can run up to him, and this is what he'll have on him. So let's give him some armor. So just right-click, click new, and just give him some armor. Let's see what armor comes up first. Let's see. I could put him in some enclave armor, but he'll look out of place. And I'll just give him some leather armor. Okay, and now that he's got it, if you just click on that again, it will load him in the armor. There he is. Now he's wearing leather armor. You can give him a weapon, so just make new again and then type wep. That'll come up with weapons. Let's give him a 44 Magnum. If you want to give him ammo, just type ammo. There is. Want to give him some 44 Magnum. Now the count part is how much he will hold. We only want him, we don't want him to have like 10 magnums on him. We don't want him to have like 10 leather armor. So we'll just leave that to 1. For ammo though, we'll change that to about 20. So now he's got 20 ammo. He'll be able to shoot the weapon 20 times. This is what the owner of the items will be. They're unessential unless you're specifically doing it for a specific task. Then you just ignore it, because that means it just belongs to anyone that has it. So if he's got it, he'll use it. If he's dead, someone will just pick it up and use it. It's just the way it is. Actor effect list is effects you can add onto him. If you want him to breathe underwater while he's swimming, although they don't tend to go underwater often, they usually just tend to swim, he'll breathe underwater. If you want him to have radiation resistance, you give him that. That's just what you do. These are the ones that are already in the game. You can make other ones. You can give him perks. You can even give them that inertia effect on from Mothership Zeta, you know, where all the aliens are all sparkling. You can actually add that to him if you wanted to. So, yeah, you can give him withdrawal, give him war heal. These are all just silly, but you can give him actor effects, and that's the way he'll do it. Animation, it's not really important. This is basically if you're building a custom race, but we're just using what's in there. We're just making an NPC to use in the game. We don't need to affect this at all. Face. This part is where you're customizing the way he looks. So hair length doesn't work in this game. It's not Oblivion. You could change how complex his tone is, how complex his face is. You can see how old he is. Young. Old. Or you could just hair colour, you can change the hair colour. I know he doesn't have hair for now, but we're going to add some hair to him, so let's change the colour of the hair to dark green. Okay, that's what colour his hair will be. So let's just generate his face. This will generate a random face. If you've not locked these, it will generate a random face. If you want to change something specific, you go to Face Advanced. This will change all parts of it. You can change the texture, so you can have a light, dark beard. Geometry, you can change the cheeks to be skinny. Look, it even looks like a bit like a corpse now. I'm going to keep that. Or you can have him a little bit more fat. You can change all the specifics of the way he looks. So now after we've made all the face the way we want it to look, we can add head parts. This is the way his hair will be. We can have that hair. There's not much hair in the ghoul section, but yeah. Wavy ghoul. I think I'll stick to that hair for now. Eyes. Choice between normal blue eyes or the other eyes. I don't think I'll just stick to ghoul. Wait. Yeah. On blood, we could change it. If you shoot him, it's what'll burst out of him, basically. So if we want, so as it's organic blood spray, it'll be red blood. But we could change it to metal. So now when you shoot him, it's like shooting a robot. He will have sparks flying off him and everything. And I think that looks pretty cool, so I want to have him as a metallic NPC. Now destruction is what happens when he dies, or after a specific amount of damage. You could add destruction data to him. If you shoot, so after you shoot him after a few times, he'll explode. You can add an explosion that's like a car. He'll blow up like a car if you really wanted to. And in fact, I won't show you specifically how to do it. I'll just do it quickly. Destruction data enabled. New. Let's give it a bust nuke explosion. Debris. Let's have robot gore bits. So now we've got like an android that explodes like a bus. Yeah, a bit overpowered, but that's the way it is. Scripts is what scripts are attached to him. So now that we've got a NPC built, you can see he's got his weapon, he's got his armor, he's got a specific face that you've built in yourself, and that is it. But he's not finished yet. If you place him into the game, he'll just stand there. Now, AI packages, what I mentioned before, is what he will do in the game, the way he will act. So now what we're going to do is add an already made package list. We're going to want a default sandbox. This means he'll walk around and do whatever he likes, when he likes, in that specific area. He'll eat. He'll converse with other people, he'll sleep, he'll just wander around. So if, now he's done that, we place him in, he'll just wander around and stay in that area. So now that NPC is complete. So now that the NPC is complete, you want to place him in game. So let's place him in Springvale. Why not? So here we go. Let's just go into world space, click on Wasteland, wait for the long list to load. And then just click on one and then type in Springvale. You don't have to specifically type into a box, you just press the letters and it will bounce down to those letters. So there we have Springvale. Double click that, and it will load it in the render window. So while that's loading, we go back to the object window. And let's type in my NPC. There he is. Count 0, and he's not used by anything, so he's completely new, fresh, unused in the game, and he's not even in the game. He's not there. Count 0 means he's not there. He's not in the game. So here's Springvale. Okay, now just scroll in. Use your mouse wheel, scroll in. Hold shift. Move the mouse, don't have to click anything, just hold shift, move the mouse to rotate. You should have learned this in other Geck tutorials that are around. So that is Springvale. Now all that's here is a enclave iBot. It's pretty lonely. So let's give him my NPC. Whoop. There he is. Now just press F and it will floor him. There we go. And there he is. He will be around that area in game. Let's just place a bed quickly. You don't have to do this, but I'm just going to show you that he will sleep. He will do whatever he wants around that area. So let's just filter, type in bed. Or let's see what's on. Ah, that bed will do. Now let's just place this bed there. No, no. Right click to rotate. Oh, we don't want that to go through the floor. And there you have it. Oh, got a bed there. So now just save it. And I'll just boot up the game and I'll show you what it's like in the game. Okay, so here we are in the small town of Springvale. And lo and behold, there's the bed. Now, where's our lovely NPC? Oh, look. There he is. Just chilling his way around.
Hey, be more careful.
He's just a nobody. As you can see, he's just sandboxing. Standing around, he'll brush around, he'll sleep, he'll eat if any food's around. He'll do whatever he wants to do. So there you have it. There's an NPC in game.
Hey there.
And it's time for me to go. I'll see you guys later.